you want to see an ongoing analysis of Ganyu, make sure to follow us on Twitter, link in the description. In short, Ganyu heavily depends on aiming her bow and delivering those frostflake arrows, while her elemental skill gives her more time to reposition herself and get rid of the enemy's attention, and when the elemental burst gets activated, she wants to stay inside the field to get the full benefit of her second passive, while the icicles rain upon her enemies. Building a team with Ganyu feels very refreshing thanks to her cryo alignment, which brings a lot of flexibility that helps you achieve various compositions. But before we form a team with her, it's important to take a look at her equipment. Obviously, the first one that comes to mind is the Wanderer's Troop artifact set, which gives a sizable 35% increased damage for her charge shots, and the two-set bonus of Elemental Mastery is also a nice way to make her melt reactions even stronger. But if you're more concerned with using her as your support damage dealer, then there's always the reliable choice of going with the 4-set Noblesse Oblige to improve your team's burst attacks, and what's even better, the 2-set bonus provides excellent damage boost to her every icicle, because when you level up her burst talent, the damage slowly increments and getting 20% from the 2-set is quite a big deal. If you don't want to get the whole 4-set bonus, you can mix it together with Blizzard Strayer 2-set, so you can end up with a nice 20% increase for your burst and cryo damage, which should give you plenty enough of useful damage support. And as for the weapons, if you're aiming to make her into your main damage dealer, then Blackleaf Bow or Viridescent Hunt are excellent choices, especially since she gains more critical damage from her ascensions. For free-to-play option, the Prototype Crescent is also surprisingly a strong option for her, while of course, if you're lucky enough, any of the 5-star weapons will be the best choice for her. However, if you want her to work as your support, then the Stringless or Favonius Warbow should do the trick. This finally brings us to team building, where Ganyu's potential can be fully realized, and one of the deadly team combinations involves using Ganyu as your main damage dealer to get together with Pyro and Animo characters, with the last team member being a situational choice that could be either another Pyro or Cryo character to activate one of the resonance bonuses. And once the team is assembled, you want to clump the enemies together into one place using Animo and make sure that your Pyro status is being swirled on them. This will then allow you to unleash a couple of Frostflake arrows that fully utilize the melt reaction on every single enemy besides the one you hit with the arrow, resulting in a beautiful bloom damage like no other. Even without this specific setup, you can still trigger plenty of melt reactions by fighting regularly. Looking at some potential teammates, Xiangling is a great choice thanks to her skill and burst that can linger on the battlefield without needing her to be there, so you can apply the Pyro status quite consistently. Then there's Sucrose, who not only provides crowd control but can also boost elemental mastery significantly, which results in more powerful elemental reactions. Finally, if you want her Frostflake arrows to deal even more damage, getting a Geo character like Noelle or the Traveler paired together with Archaic Petra will provide a nice elemental damage bonus, not to mention the crystals you pick up will provide a shield that will keep you safe from enemy interruptions while it lasts. So to quickly recap, Ganyu's unique nature of her charge shots allows her to capitalize on melt reactions without relying on her elemental skill or burst, while at the same time she can also deliver very formidable damage as a support character, and thanks to excellent artifact and weapon choices that are available for bow users, building a team with her is an exciting experience. The long-awaited arrival of Kokugoat is finally over, and there's a lot of things that make her extremely fascinating. First of all, her talents are a mix between Mona and Amber, which might give the first impression that she's entirely focused on supportive damage, but in reality, thanks to her alignment to Cryo Element, and the fact that her critical damage increases with ascensions, makes her into a valid choice for being the main damage dealer, although it will require some setup to make her function at her best. And that's what's most important about her. In a controlled environment where you are within a safe distance from enemies and have a reliable way of either applying freeze or melt, you can expect to hit enemies with your Frostflake arrows that are almost in the same league as an elemental skill, except there's no cooldown and it just depends on your positioning and timing. This also means that because of the way you need to set up her charge shots, you are leaving her exposed to enemy attacks, and getting interrupted is no fun, so using someone from the geo to generate shields or dropping your elemental skill at the right time requires some finessing, which is something that's not a problem to characters like Diluc or Razor, who just smashed the enemy faces without minding their surroundings too much. Overall, Ganyu is definitely a very unique character that brings absolutely amazing damage thanks to her Frostflake arrows that can wipe out a cluster of enemies with no problems whatsoever, and part of the reason why these shots are in a league of their own is thanks to the melt reaction, which is considered to be one of the best elemental reactions for endgame due to how it scales with every single stat including elemental mastery. However, everything comes with a price, and in this case, the gameplay style of charge shots makes the character move slowly and expose exposed to enemy attacks, so you need to find a way to mitigate this risk. Then there's also the potential ruin of missing your shots and wasting your damage, which is something that could be devastating, especially in time trials like the Spiral Abyss. And yet, despite all of this, Ganyu is the first character that makes you appreciate the intended design of bold gameplay of actually using your aim shots and delivering massive damage, and thanks to several significant boosts she gets from her talents and teammates, her performance is absolutely amazing. Let us know in the comments if you will be wishing for the legendary Coco Goat. Also, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification on, as well as gently press the like button. And don't forget to follow us on Twitter for up-to-date news. Thank you for watching us.